Live from the Ring of Fire, Mike Papantonio.
Last week, bus drivers in New York took to the streets. They wanted to protest a plan by officials to privatize school buses, along with everything else that's being privatized. This idea is popping up all over the country. A Republican-controlled legislatures and governors, they want to strip state employees of every union protection possible, everything they've earned over the years. Join me to talk about the strike and what it means not just for New York, but for everybody. Larry Hanley's the president of the Amalgamated Transit Union. Larry, this is not just about what's happening in New York, is it?
No, it's not, Mike. It's good to be with you again. Thank you for having me on.
Sure.
Actually, what's happening in New York is that a service which has really been private for many years, but operated through a contract with the Department of Education of the city of New York, has had employee protections. There has been an agreement since 1979 that whatever company is successful in getting the bid and being awarded the contract must provide the existing experienced workforce with jobs and with their current wages and benefits. And what's happened is that a bid has been put out by the city which strips the workers of that protection. So, I'm sorry, go ahead.
Yeah, but I mean, is part of this story is we start understanding that we've let the courts be absolutely packed to the point that the new trend of these packed court appointments is to say to unions, you can't do this, you can't do that. And this is an example. This came about because you had a court up in New York who wouldn't allow certain very important protections for the worker to be put into the agreement.
Well, there was a court decision about a year ago involving a separate piece of the industry. And, you know, we don't believe that that has an impact on this particular bid. But that is what the mayor is resting his case on. He is saying he's prohibited by law from entering into a bid that protects workers. There are many other ways that it could be done, but the mayor thus far has not been interested in pursuing those. So he's saying that his two issues are the costs are too high and that it is illegal. And he's wrong, certainly, on the illegal part.
Okay, so with this privatization enthusiasm that's working its way through all of the Republican governor houses, through all the Republican legislatures, what we see is it's not really even about quality anymore, is it? It's about, now in this situation, I think what's important is you deal with thousands of children who have disabilities, vulnerable children, working parents, kids have disability, adults are rarely around to think about, you know, how do we deal with this if you don't have trained adults?
That's right. And what we have now is an experienced workforce that knows how to deal with children with various disabilities. We have situations where children require two attendants, for example, to carry them up and down six flights of stairs every day. And that's the kind of work that our people do. And the position that the mayor has been taking is that people who do that kind of work, who get paid $15 an hour in New York City, are overpaid.
Mm. Okay, so has the blame game started where the mayor, this is a typical Republican approach, and that is to blame the selfish worker, blame the shameless, selfish worker who is putting themselves ahead of the children's best interest and not talking about how much of a sacrifice that worker has done for the last 20 years, but it's always pitting the worker against the broader public. Is that happening?
Well, yeah, and in this case, what they're trying to do is pit the worker, the bus driver and the matron on those buses, against the kids, which is preposterous. And let me tell you, our parents support our drivers. There have been numerous press conferences already held with the parents of these kids saying the mayor is wrong and the union is right. But unfortunately, the mayor is getting some very bad advice, and he has taken it.
Well, again, we started this program talking about we have become the America of Rahm Emanuel, where people are far less important than the bottom line. And that's happening here. I mean, we can see that clearly. But what does it mean if it succeeds there? Isn't it just the same old thing? You go to Rick Scott in Florida, the predictable, lump of, whatever you know, whatever corporate America wants, Rick Scott's going to deliver. Whatever the Republicans want, he's going to deliver. You go to Scott Walker, you go to Corbett in Pennsylvania. This just takes a life of all of its own to where we go to the lowest bidder, not really caring what the quality of that bid is.
Well, that's right. And this is an example of where privatization has been in place for a very long time. But now the mayor of New York is saying that the private contracts cost the city too much. And the solution is to make workers who average $38,000 a year between the drivers and the matrons to take them and drive their wages down to make the service cheaper. And that is where we've gone. You know, 10 years ago, they wouldn't quite say that. They would just say, well, we can do things more efficiently. Now they're saying it. Now they're saying, you know, American workers need to make less money.
Yeah. And so in $15 an hour in New York City, I mean, really? And the governor's saying that's just too much money. I mean, Bloomberg, the mayor, saying that's just too much money. Right. And so where does this land? Give me your predictions on it.
Well, it's very hard to say because we have a lame duck mayor who is apparently worth about $30 billion personally, who mm-hmm. believes that working people who will live below the poverty line, if he's successful, need to take cuts in pay. I think we have a rock and we have a hard place, and I think we're going to have a very tough battle. I can't predict how long it will be because I don't know at what point the mayor will come to his senses.
So parents are parents seeing through the lie, though, the lie that, you know, we need to hire somebody for $12 an hour and they're going to take just as good of our children, care of our children as the person who's been at it for 20 years, who's trained in the safety, trained in, I mean, what are the things that can go wrong are overwhelming. I mean, just operating the bus is just part of it, isn't it?
Yeah, they are. And the parents are completely aware of that. You know, the parents interact every day, especially, you know, the part of the work that has been put out for bid without employee protections is the work for handicapped kids. And those parents know their driver personally. They trust them. They feel good when they put their child on that driver's bus and when the matron is with them. They know them. They trust them. And, you know, to break that entire bond of trust and just say we're going to have a constantly churning, low-paid workforce is something the parents know is wrong. And they're with us. They're standing with us in this fight.
Well, as the fight goes on, do you expect this to fight, you know, this same type of thing, not just with this one story, but we're going to see this again. It's a test. I mean, you always see the other side come in and test. And they're using this as a test market, aren't they?
I believe that, and the entire labor movement in New York City believes that. We know that this is a battleground for all of us.
Okay, so if they succeed, what does everything look like at this point? I mean, what happens if they succeed? If they bust the union, what happens?
Well, I think that it becomes a prelude to what they'll do everywhere else in the country. But this is no different than what the test we had in Wisconsin and in Michigan last year. It's the same thing. It's just the same ideology being pushed by the same rich people. And ultimately, you know, I think we all have to wonder at what point the social fabric just comes apart. At what point do working people just realize that the only way to deal with this is to fight back and fight back hard? You know, and at that point, I think you have Greece. I think you have, you know, the things that have been going on in Europe, you know, as a result of the attacks by the government there on their people, or things that are going to happen here.
What are the possibilities, really, Larry? I think it comes down to this in my mind. What are the possibilities of a man who's worth $30 billion to understand that $15 an hour, $15 doesn't even buy a sandwich in New York City? Mm-hmm. Thank you for joining me. Good luck with the strike.
Thank you very much, Mike.